some high memories of Roy go back about 40 years ago, when Penny and I used to go to Latin Quarter on Saturday nights. And one night, Penny's a different looking person there. It's a man with a long beard. He's wearing a light, almost anything like trench coat. It's in March, he's a good dress for the weather, but not fashionable, certainly. And he's carrying what appears to be jean bags of textbooks. So that was around the time when he was a singer, so they had that, around 1978. So then I have a compilation of some memories from other people, from Bob, Colin, Carol, who remembers being at Lloyd's 50th birthday at the Game of the Latin Quarter. And then, and apparently he was a regular visitor at that place, which was on Kent Street, and he was a banquet restaurant entertainment on Saturday nights. There was also a story of Roy being terrified of being surrounded by meteoric flashes of lightning, even though he was traveling in a car. And being at an activist demonstration in the early 90s, when he said to people on the opposing sides, be kind to yourselves. Myself, I met Roy probably in the late 90s, just in the pick of his walking through the market, and he saw me and said, you look familiar, I'm Roy, what's your name? And from then we always chatted whenever we saw each other at various events. I remember Roy being a focal fixture at art gallery openings, especially at the Arts Project in recent years. He was very thrilled to invite people to his 70th and 75th birthdays with parties which I attended in open houses. However, I missed his 80th. And that's sort of why maybe I'm speaking today, because I feel like a woman way back. Even I was told about that day, just couldn't make it to the open house. But I did, was able to congratulate him at his, about 10 days later at Bill's Paul's birthday at Scott's Corner. I remember Roy speaking and saying, I'll see you all at my 85th. I guess he won't be here with us physically for that. But anyway, one of my, I guess the last conversations I had with him, he heard about the passing away of a much younger friend of his. And he mentioned to me they wanted to speak to me, and said the person gave me the, told me the reason why the person had to distance himself from an activist group. And I think it was real closure for a lot of us in the group, that we had kind of lost track of someone, and then Roy kind of bridged that gap between the person who had sort of vanished temporarily and our group. And my last memory of him was that the Colors of Latin America late January, and he was there talking to people. I just kind of said hi, but I didn't really get to speak to him. And I'm sorry now we didn't have a conversation that day, because I think I spoke to him earlier. And I guess just really grateful to Roy that he connected so many people throughout his lifetime. And I'm very sad that he has passed away, but I'm sure he's still with us and he'll continue to connect us. Thanks a lot.